You know that once upon a time I didn't need you so. It would have been so easy then for me to turn and go. But now there's no leaving you. I know that for a fact. I'm at the point of no return, and for me there'll be no turning back.
And a half ticks away from the hour of 1 o'clock right now on the Rex Jones Go. This is Tommy Roll. He includes just about everybody.
Further report, after we have just received word that shots had been fired at the Kennedy motorcade, we just talked with the police department. Here was that conversation.
Several persons arrived at Parkland, and no information is being given at this time.
But you did have reports of shots being fired.
We had reports, yes, sir.
KLIF News on Ritz Apartment Hospital to confirm the reports that someone had been wounded in the firing of shots in the Kennedy motorcade in downtown Dallas. Stay tuned to Klif News.
Called Everybody, and that's instant survey sound number one for about the fourth day in a row.
Refreshing as the land of startled water. That's the big red state that has us captured.
To all Texas, the people at Hams say thank you. Yes, thanks for making Hams beer such a favorite. It's got the famous taste that thousands of Texans are enjoying every day. In fact, somewhere in Texas, someone is opening and enjoying a Hams beer every 3 seconds. This weekend is a perfect time to refresh yourself with a tall, cold Hams beer. Thanks again for the spectacular welcome. They would suggest you stock up for the weekend with Texas Brewed Premium Hams beer at popular Texas prices.
Refreshing as the land of skies of water. That's the big red taste of Hams.
Hey, be sure that you stock up for this weekend with Texas Brewed Premium Hams beer at popular Texas prices.
And now we take you to Joe Long in KLIF Mobile News Unit number 4 in downtown Dallas.
The latest information, and things are rather confused at this moment, shots definitely were fired at the presidential motorcade as it passed through downtown Dallas. All squads are converging code 3 in the area of Elm and Houston in downtown. There is a tentative description of the shooting suspect, a man, a white male, believed to be approximately 30 years old, reportedly armed with a .30 caliber rifle. How many shots were fired? How many persons, if any, were struck and wounded? We do not know yet. Very close-mouthed officials now clamping down on the entire story. We'll bring you what details are available just as quickly as they come into our possession. Joe Long, the
about the wild teenage sex. But wait till you see the scrapes my dad Jimmy Stewart gets into and take her, she's mine. Yikes, you just wouldn't believe it. Can you picture Jimmy Stewart battling the police?
Grab him, boys.
No!
No! Oh, no! No!
Mixed up with some French cuties.
Holy chihuahua.
Doing a Parisian striptease. Yikes, you just gotta see our new picture. Take her, she's mine, to believe it.
A wonderful Broadway smash is even funnier on the movie screen. Take her, she's mine. The hilarious story of a father whose baby suddenly becomes a babe. So take her, take him, take the family to see James Stewart and Sandra Dee in Take Her, She's Mine, co-starring Audrey Meadows, from 20th Century Fox in Color by Deluxe. Take Her, She's Mine.
I'll do it, friend, if you don't watch me very closely. It's the surprise fun show of the season, now held over for a third big week at Interstate Palace Theater in Dallas.
On a time, I didn't need you so. It would have been so easy then for me to turn and go. But now there's no leaving you. I know that for a fact. I'm at the point of no return, and for me there'll be no turning back. You'd always be a habit I could break. But now a day without your kiss would be so hard to take. You just can't get off a train that's moving down the track. I'm at the point of no return, and for me there'll be no turning back. Have said goodbye, but that was at the start. Now I think I'd rather die than be the one to say we'll part. Maybe you will break my heart, or maybe you'll be true. No matter what the future brings, I've got to see it through. Nothing but an act. I'm at the point of no return, and for me there'll be no turning back. Yeah, for me there'll be no turning back.
McDaniels with a KLIF classic, and ladies and gentlemen, stand by at 1190 on your dial for further developments in the reported shooting during the motorcade of President Kennedy on his visit to Dallas, Texas.
Are you hoping that someday you'll find something that's really good for pimples and bad complexion? Search no more. Baker's Beauty Lotion is what you need. A brand new modern formula, safe, easy, and pleasant to use. Mrs. H.W. Hedgepeth, 1044 Garden View Drive, Dallas, says,
my grandson had pimples all over his face, and Baker's Beauty Lotion sure has done wonders for him. I heartily recommend it for pimples and skin blemishes. Baker's Beauty Lotion is in the class with the old reliable Baker's Hair Tonic for dandruff.
For pimples and bad complexion, Baker's Beauty Lotion is the best yet. It's a new formula containing no harmful ingredients, plus easy, safe to use. Those who use Baker's Beauty Lotion face the world with a clear face or money back.
And now another report from Joe Long, downtown Dallas.
Latest details on the chase and search in downtown Dallas. An unidentified man fired several shots from what apparently was a high-powered 30-caliber rifle at the presidential motorcade. So far, the authorities are not releasing details on who, if anyone, was hit by any of the bullets or how badly they were injured. Parkland Hospital being very closed-mouthed about the situation, but the search now centers at the area of Elm and Houston near the old Texas School Book Depository building, and there is a possibility that the would-be assassin is still inside that building. All available downtown units are converging at emergency speed to that area. The entire area has been blocked off. It is roped off now. No one allowed in or out as the search for this would-be presidential assassin continues in downtown Dallas. what had been a very smooth journey to Texas for the president and his wife and other officials, Vice President and Mrs. Lyndon Johnson, now has turned in to another black smear. And we are keeping up to date on all details through the official police officer sources and will bring you full details as soon as they're available. Joe Long, Zip Mobile News Unit number 41190, and out.
I do 90% of your work. I'm Babbo Cleanser. Grease dissolving, stain removing, powerful new Babbo. Now, do you believe me?
Isn't it time for Aunt Jemima Day at your house?
This is Jerry DeLon in the KLIF newsroom. The police department is still trying to confirm the fact that President Kennedy and Governor John Connally have been wounded, perhaps tragically, in a morning afternoon altercation in downtown area. According to the latest reports, both have been cut down by at least three bullets that pierced the atmosphere as the motorcade made its way from Love Field through to that downtown area to the trademark where President Kennedy was to speak at a luncheon. They were riding in an open automobile when the shots were fired. The bubble had been discarded when the sun broke through the clouds here in Big D. The president, his body cradled in the arms of Mrs. Kennedy, has been rushed to Parkland Hospital. We are still awaiting word from Parkland, the extent of the president's injury. We just talked with the police department just a moment ago. Here was that conversation.
Did you get any more confirmation that the president
has? No, sir.
Can you give me the description again, please, ma'am?
We're awfully busy right now. Did you get it on your radio? It's white male, 35, 10, 165, 30 caliber rifle, and I believe it was at Elman, Houston, where it came from. Now, I don't know definitely, and I don't like to say.
Thank you.
That was the police department, Mrs. Trenton, saying that they have not received a confirmed report. And now we'll switch you to the downtown area of Dallas, and this is Joe Long.
Here is the latest unconfirmed report we have, and we must stress that this is unconfirmed, but it comes from a very high-placed official who refuses to be quoted, but it is now reported that Governor Connally and the president perhaps have been wounded in this assassin's attempt. It is an unofficial report that both the president and Governor Connally were wounded in this shooting event in the downtown area during the passage of the motorcade. The automobile in which the president was riding reportedly sped out to Parkland Hospital, and we do not know whether Mrs. Kennedy and or Mrs. Connally suffered any injury at all. The first report we had said that both of the men were lying prone in the automobile in the caravan limousine at the time it made its way rapidly to Parkland Hospital. We have no further details. Parkland Hospital is being placed almost off limits to reporters at this time, but those details that are available will be brought to you just as quickly as we possibly can. Very briefly recapping, there has been an assassination attempt in downtown Dallas. Shots fired from a high-powered rifle at the presidential car in the motorcade as it was en route to the trademark for a scheduled presidential speech. All of these security precautions that have been taken, and now this happens. And the police are converging on and surrounding the area of Elman, Houston, the old Texas School Book Exchange building, where they believe they may have trapped the would-be assassin. We'll bring you further details momentarily. Joe Long, with Mobile News Unit number 41190, and out.
Gary DeLon back at the KLIO studios, issuing the bulletin again for the man armed with a .30-30 caliber rifle. He was described as about 5'10", 165 pounds, of slender build, about 30 to 35 years old. This tragic incident occurred at Elman, Houston, as the motorcade was en route to the trademark for a noon luncheon. The president, of course, was to deliver the speech during his appearance in Big D. Newsmen, some five car lengths behind the president, heard what sounded like three bursts of gunfire. Secret Service agents in the auto following the president quickly pulled automatic rifles. The bubble, as we've mentioned previously, on the president's car was down when the shots rang out. The president slumped over the back seat, face down. Governor Connally lay on the floor of the rear seat. Wounds in the governor's chest were clearly visible. The wounds indicated an automatic weapon had been used. Police say this is believed to be a .30 caliber pistol, rather rifle. Three loud bursts of gunfire, possible tragedy on this November 22nd in Big D. We're going to switch now to the trademark, and here is a statement from Gordon McClendon.
Gordon McClendon at the trademark in Dallas. Here, the scene is of wild pandemonium as 2,000 guests waited anxiously for President Kennedy, Governor Connally, and the Vice President. Now, rumors run rampant. No one here knows what has happened, but the rumors continue to circulate that the President and Governor Connally both have been shot. And here at the trademark, we have nothing but rumors and a wild scene of chaos. This is Gordon McClendon from the trademark in Dallas.
That was Gordon McClendon from the trademark in Dallas. Again, we are still trying to get confirmed reports from Parkland Hospital that President Kennedy and Governor Connally have been cut down by an assassin's bullet, a fusillade of bullets, at the intersection of Elm and Houston in downtown Dallas. It is impossible, and it was impossible at that time to tell where the president was hit, but bullet wounds in Connally's chest clearly indicated that he had been wounded in that region. There were three loud bursts visibly heard by members of the motorcade. Motorcycle officers escorting the president quickly leaped from their bikes and raced up a grassy hill. That description again, a man about 5'10", 165 pounds, about 30 years of age. He was armed with a .30 caliber rifle. He was of slender build. The police department has thrown out an extensive dragnet. We are still trying to get in touch with Parkland Hospital. We hope to have confirmation. The latest report that we have from one press source, Clint Hill, a Secret Service agent assigned to Mrs. Kennedy, said he's dead as the president was lifted from the rear of the White House touring car. Mr. Kennedy was rushed to the Parkland Hospital emergency room. Other White House officials were in doubt as the corridors of the hospital erupted in pandemonium. The incident occurred at Elm and Houston in the downtown area as the motorcade winded its way through the region. Newsmen in the motorcade did hear the three bursts from the automatic rifle. It is impossible, and was so at the time, to tell where the chief executive was struck by the bullets. We are now in contact with one of our news units, and we are going to switch you now for another report from the downtown section of Dallas.
So long again, and Cliff Mobile News Unit number 4, and the police cordon and the widespread search net continues. We still do not know whether this would-be assassin is trapped in the building or in the area at all. The search continues. We're going to vacate this mobile unit momentarily, and we'll be back in touch with you just as quickly as possible. KLIF newsman and mobile unit spread throughout all the strategic spots covering this story. We'll bring you full details momentarily. Joe Long, Cliff Mobile News Unit number 4, 1190 and out.
The possible tragedy came after President Kennedy arrived 3 minutes late at Love Field as his big jet plane with number one on its side floated down to earth, and the sun broke through the clouds after the president was 10 minutes away leaving Fort Worth. He was 10 minutes late. He was 3 minutes late arriving at Dallas Love Field. An estimated 250,000 persons lined the streets this afternoon as the president's motorcade moved through the streets. Then, at 12:50 p.m. Central Time, acting White House News Secretary Malcolm Kilduff was asked whether the president was dead. He said, "I have no word now," and that is the word we are awaiting. I have no word now, the latest. Congressman Jim Wright of Fort Worth has just said that both President Kennedy and Governor Connally were seriously wounded in the attack, but were alive. This is the latest. Congressman Jim Wright of Fort Worth has said that both President Kennedy and Governor Connally were seriously wounded, but were still alive. And now, here is KLIF's Joe Long.
Still no official word from Parkland Hospital. We were en route from Love Field, where we had described the arrival of the presidential party And that is when the first word of the shooting came out. We have been in the deep downtown area, in the area of Elm and Houston, and the dragnet continues. So far, Parkland Hospital has not released an official statement on the condition of President Kennedy and Governor John Connally. We do know now, however, that both of these men were wounded in the assassination attempt, and the dragnet and search continues. We are finding these details slow in coming. We have many official and unofficial comments coming from various sources. But at this moment, let's summarize it this way. As the presidential motorcade made its way through downtown Dallas, at least three shots rang out in the vicinity of Elm and Houston. And one child reportedly was a witness to the shooting. A young colored boy said that as he heard the first shot, he looked up at the fourth floor window of the old Texas Schoolbook Exchange building and saw a man leaning from the window, and then he fired at least two more shots. The report we had from witnesses at the scene said that both the president and Governor Connally were lying prone in the presidential limousine as it sped to Parkland Hospital. From Parkland, Congressman Jim Wright of Fort Worth says both Kennedy and Connally were seriously wounded but are still alive. However, we must stress that this is an unofficial report. It is not a medical report. Here is a description now of the man who fired the shots.
We're awfully busy right now. Did you get it on your radio? Or it's Whitefield, 3510, 165, 30 caliber rifle. And I believe it was at Elm and Houston where it came from. Now, I don't know definitely, and I don't like to say.